evening. The kids have been working hard. They've been working on the Christmas story, the birth of John, the birth of Jesus, all the things that God was doing to allow us to know that God actually loves us and wants to know us and came to live among us so that we could know Him. I've really enjoyed having the kids in Kids Club. It's been a wonderful group this year. For the most part, we haven't wanted to meet too many of them with the others. And they've really done a good job and seem to have had fun and do a wonderful time. When we get done today, we have punch and cookies down in Fellowship Hall. They're also going to have a visit from Santa Claus. So don't just run off with them. Because, like I said, Santa Claus will be down there along with the punch and cookies. Before we get started, you guys are about ready?
Yeah.
Are you guys about ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Let's have a word of prayer. Dearest Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to tell the story of your birth. We come before you this evening, Lord, we ask for your help in telling the story. Help us to tell it with joy and help others to hear it in joy. Bless this time. Give our narrators strong voices and give all of our actors the spirit of those who they portray. Be in this time, Lord. Bring us a blessing. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. Your thing won't turn off.
In the days of King Herod of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah. to enter the sanctuary of the Lord and offer incense. Now at the time of the incense offering, the whole assembly of the people were praying outside. Then there appeared to him an angel of the Lord standing at the right side of the altar of incense. When Zechariah saw him, he was terrified and fear overwhelmed him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, for your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you will name him John. You will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth. For he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He must never drink wine or strong drink. Even before his birth, he will be filled with the Holy Spirit. He will turn many of the people of Israel to the Lord their God. With the spirit and power of Elijah, he will go before him to turn the hearts of parents to their children and the disobedient to the wisdom of the righteous, to make ready the people prepared for the Lord." Zechariah said to the angel, "How will I know that this is so? For I am an old man and my wife is getting on in years." The angel replied, "I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news. But now, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled in their time, you will become mute and unable to speak until the day these things occur."
Meanwhile, the people were waiting for Zechariah and wondered at his delay in the sanctuary. When he did come out, he could not speak to them, and they realized that he had seen a vision in the sanctuary. He kept motioning to them and remained unable to speak. When his time of service was ended, he went to his home.
After those days, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and for 5 months she remained in seclusion. She said, "This is what the Lord has done for me, for he looked favorably on me and took away the disgrace I have endured among the people."
In the 6th month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, for a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came and heard favored one, "The Lord is with you." And she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, but you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him on his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said to the angel, "How can this be since I'm a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the 6th month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
house of Zachariah and Elizabeth. And Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and screamed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord."
And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed. For the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts.
He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and set the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever." And Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home.
And now the time came for Elizabeth to give birth, and she bore a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown his great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her.
Rejoice!
On the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child, and they were going to name Zachariah after his father. But his mother said, "No, he is to be called John." They said to her, "None of your relatives has this name." Then they began motioning to his father to hide.
plans to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet.
"Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until he had born a son, and he named him Jesus."
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration. It was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expected.
in the town of King Herod.
Now join us on page 240 for Hark the Herald Angels Sing, verses 1 and 2.
Where the sun.
God bless and have a great Christmas season. Thank you for your time.